let's discuss today about Bloch sphere, where the eigenstates of the x, y and z operators, otherwise poly x, poly y and poly z operators, lie on the Bloch sphere. And also let's see how the generic form of a qubit, that is psi equals to alpha 0 plus beta 1, or more general is being cos theta by 2 0 cat plus e power I phi sin theta by 2 1 cat, this thing emerges out of the simple polar spherical representation. Okay, so let's see. So we have our Bloch sphere here. I take this as the z axis, this as the y axis, so this is y cap, this is z cap, and this is x cap, x, y and z, three axis. Now I define a quantum state here, let's say, okay, which is at an angle theta from the z axis. And this plane, okay, this plane in the, this plane which is perpendicular to xy makes an angle of phi with the x-axis. Alright. Further, I set the radius of this quantum state vector r to be 1. Okay, so this is basically, this is a vector from the center which is on the sphere. Okay, and this vector is of unit length, so I set its radius equals to 1. Then certainly the point of the coordinates of this point is given by x, y, z, or your r, theta and phi in the polar spherical representation. And let's define them. If I have the quantum state, so let's say v represent the quantum state vector, then certainly this v is some v1 x cap plus v2 y cap plus v3 z cap, right? Okay, yeah, this is the usual Cartesian coordinate representation of a vector. And in the polar representation, spherical polar representation, the v1 would be, v1 is the x component, right? So the x component is basically this component. So this component here would be first this component. This component is this. If this is r, then this component is usually r sine theta, right? And this component here, this one, is r cos theta. We have r equals 1, so they are just sin theta and cos theta. Now, if this vector is r sin theta, then we need this component, the x component. Then we can see this x component would be given by this thing along with the cos phi. Because now this is a plane. Okay, this is the plane now, and in this plane, this vector is decomposed into this x and this y axis. So this is going to be r sin theta cos phi. Since r equals to 1, I write it as cos phi. Okay. Similarly, v2 is sin theta sin phi. Sin theta sin phi. Okay. Sin theta and this angle is sin of phi. And v3 equals to cos theta. This one. Because that is the z component. Okay. Then, the block vector. This is the block vector, the quantum state vector is also called as the block vector here. Can be written as sin theta cos phi times x cap plus sin theta sin phi times y cap plus cos theta times. This is the block vector. What else do we know here? We also know that, okay, to that point we will go a bit later. Now, we know that the usual representation of a qubit is the following. We write psi equals to alpha 0 plus beta 1, because it's a two level system and some part of 0 state and some part of 1 state is there, alpha and beta. Further, this alpha and beta are complex number and their modulus square adds up to 1 to normalize the state, to make its probability 1. Okay. Now, I take alpha and beta are complex numbers, so R1 e power I theta 1 and alpha 2 to be R2 e power I theta 2. Okay? If I plug in them, sorry, alpha, not alpha 2 here, this is beta. If I plug in, then my quantum state looks like R1 e power I theta 1 0 plus R2 e power I theta 2. What I do next is I take a e power I theta 1 common. So e power I theta 1 I take outside and I remain with R1 0 plus e power I theta 2 minus theta 1 R2 1. Now, because if you multiply here, it become R1 e power I theta 1, the older coefficient, and if you multiply here, it becomes I theta 2 and e power minus I theta 1, so e power minus I theta 1 e power plus I theta 1 makes 1 and what survives is pi. Okay? Now, this thing which is otherwise called as a global phase has no measurable effect. Basically, you cannot measure it, or it's just a spectator here. It doesn't do anything, so it can be always ignored, the global phase. So my psi is just equivalent to this. Okay, R1 times 0, then e power I theta 2 minus theta 1 R2. Alright. Now, next thing what I do is I take R1 as cos theta by 2 and R2 as sin theta by 2. You might ask me why do I do this? I would give the reason. And theta 2 minus theta 1 I take as phi. I randomly take it And I would just see if it works. And I would show you that it actually works and it fits to what we will need. And this is the reason this parameterization is done. So then my psi would finally become cos of theta by 2 0 plus e power I phi sine of theta by 2. Cos of theta by 2 0 r1 plus cos theta by 2 e power I phi theta 1 plus theta 2 minus theta 1 is phi sine theta by 2 1. And this is the most general representation of a cube. Most general, you know. Now we can see if theta equals to 0, okay, then sine theta by 2 becomes 0 and this term completely vanishes. What I am left with is that 0. So this implies psi to be equals to 0. Okay, and when I take my theta equals along with phi equals to 0, phi thing doesn't matter actually. If I take my theta to be pi, then cos pi by 2, cos 90 becomes 0, so this term vanishes, and here it becomes sine pi by 2, which is 1, and then 1 state, and there is a e power I phi, and if you e power I phi, even if it is there, it does nothing basically, okay, because it's anyway, it becomes now a global phase, if I just am left with this state, but still, not to even keep that, you take phi equals to 0, and this equation gives your psi to be 1. And now see, if you actually see the geometrical picture, the geometric picture, then if you take this theta to be 0, then it falls along the z-axis, and that is indeed where the 0 state lies. This we conventionally denote as our 0 state. And when this theta becomes pi, so this factor here, because this angle becomes pi, okay, down here, we have our 1 here. This. So you could see how parameterizing it as theta by 2 works here. As in parameterizing the r1 as cos theta by 2 works. Just because I took that as cos theta by 2, now I could easily put them into this particular fitting where I could take my z-axis and the top of the z-axis denotes the 0 and the bottom of the z-axis denotes 1. Also, I must tell you that this 0 and 1 here are nothing but the eigenvectors of sigma z. Likewise, the eigenvectors of y, that is sigma y, are 0 plus 1 by root 2, 0 plus I times 1 by root 2, and 0 minus I 1 by root 2. Alright. And accordingly, these two eigenstates lies in the y-axis. So the state here is 0 plus I times 1 by root 2, alright, and then the state in the negative end of the y-axis, the state is 0 minus I1 by root 2. So you could see the if it is y-axis, then the two ends, the positive end and the negative end, represents nothing but the two eigenstate of the poly y orbit. Similarly, in the z case, the positive eigenvalue, the eigenstate is at 0 and the negative eigenstate is 1. So they lie at the two ends of the z-axis. Similarly, for the x operator, the eigenstates are 0 plus 1 by root 2 and 0 minus 1 by root 2. So in this axis, at this end and this end, in the positive side here, the state that lies is 0 plus 1 by root 2 at this point. And at this point, the other side of this x lies 0 minus 1 by root 2. Yeah, so let's, so that's what about, this is all about the Bloch sphere, as in a very basic and a very generic overview of the Bloch sphere, the usual quantum representation, why this is cos theta by 2 0 plus e power I phi sin theta by 2. Where and all the basic eigenstates lie and why so, and I believe this would give you a good overview of the Bloch sphere, the Bloch vector, and where the quantum states lie. Thank you.